The Halloween season means many things to many people. To some, it's trick-or-treating. To others, it's a boozy good time at a Halloween party or music festival. And to others, it was skeleton theater.
You are a toy! You weren't the real Buzz Lightyear, you're an action figure! You are a child's plaything!
But to me and many others, Halloween is the time of theme park haunts. Yes, every year, theme parks big and small put on events with haunted houses, scare zones, and delicious seasonal offerings. One of the biggest names in this field is Halloween Horror Nights, put on by Universal Studios and appearing in all of their resorts. But I'm not here to talk about the history. No, I'm here to talk about the properties I want to see them utilize. Most likely, if you clicked on this video, you know that Halloween Horror Nights is no stranger to intellectual properties, or IPs for short, as the themes for their haunted houses. And before we go any further, I have to say that I take no ownership of these ideas or the IPs that I'm about to mention, should Universal Creative or anyone else elect to create them. And with that being said, here's 10 things on my HHN wish list. Number 10. Starting out with the second most obscure IP on this list, I'd love to see a haunted house based on the 1992 FMV cult classic, Night Trap. This Sega CD cheese fest would be perfect for a haunted house. The story of a bunch of teenage girls having a sleepover at a house filled with augers is just silly enough to be a good base to work from.
What is an auger? A vampire victim who's been half-bled and left there to die.
Poor creatures have just enough blood to survive, but not enough to become vampires.
Have the girls, the augers, and even the trap built into the house as jump scares? Blast that theme song and you've got yourself a fun addition to any HHN.
Vampires, you gotta be jamming me.
Bonus points if you put it in Hollywood right next to Super Nintendo World.
And let me say that for the record, I want to state that Night Trap will never appear on a Nintendo system.
And speaking of Nintendo, number 9. With Nintendo making its presence more known across the Universal parks, I think it's time for some of its more spookier properties to make their way into HHN. Namely, this GameCube classic has now become a full-fledged franchise, with two additional sequels, Mario Kart courses, and even Smash Brothers stages. So I think it would make for an awesome attraction or haunted house. I personally would sway more towards attractions, so that it could be a permanent dark ride addition to Super Nintendo World. My concept would be a sort of kid's first haunted house, in which guests would be armed with their own poltergust, and once jump-scared by the projected ghosts, they would then have the opportunity to suck up said ghosts. It'd be a great way to introduce kids to the concept of fear being fun, and it'd be lots of fun for anyone who grew up with any of the games. Moving on to our final stop from Nintendo Land, number 8. Last entry, I talked about how Nintendo has some spooky stuff under its belt, and yeah. And I think one of its surprisingly scariest properties is, now this could work as a haunted house pretty easily. However, I have a different idea. You may remember in my review of the extraterrestrial alien encounter, I mentioned that the attraction could easily be rethemed to a Guardians of the Galaxy experience. It would also work great as a Metroid attraction. Guests would board a simulator disguised as a ship and join Samus on a search for a derelict planet when they discover that on the way, your ship had picked up some X-parasites. The crew is infected by the parasites before they crash the ship and proceed to shut down its power, locking guests in their chairs. While the crew attempts to kill the now captive recruits, Samus is able to restore power, dispatch the infected crew members, and send you through a short scare maze filled with other Metroid creatures as you escape the planet and take a much shorter simulated flight back to Earth. Now, why make this an attraction and not just a scare maze?
Like, honestly, there's no reason for me to go on those rides at Halloween Horror Nights.
I tell people not to go on the rides anyway when they're going like these haunt events. It's like, it only happens once a year. Why would you waste your time going on all
the
rides?
And if you're doing it, save it till the end of the night after you've done all the mazes.
I think this would be a great incentive to bring people with that mindset towards attractions and even potentially create a new market of temporary attractions at haunt events that aren't just overlays. But even if they go with just a regular scare maze to represent Metroid, I think it would be a great addition to any year of HHN. Number 7. Moving from one unfortunately lesser known property to another, we have one of the earliest films from a fantastic actor and one of the best sci-fi horror films I've ever seen be made on a low budget. Way back in 2011, the second movie that John Boyega was ever in was about an invasion of pitch-black gorilla-like aliens with glowing teeth and a group of unlikely allies that try to defend their territory from those monsters. Watching the movie, The Haunted House writes itself, and with a sequel in the works, this has a very high potential of it happening in the future if Universal is willing to license it. And if so, refer to my statement near the start of this video that I take no ownership of the IP or the concept should Universal pursue its usage for a future HHN event. And speaking of haunted houses that write themselves... Number 6. Okay, this is such a blatantly obvious maze, I'm surprised it hasn't happened yet. Honestly, why hasn't this happened yet? It'd be so easy to convert into a haunted house, and it's extremely well known, and given the strong ties between Universal Studios Parks and Steven Spielberg, it's genuinely shocking to me that this hasn't happened yet. Also, technically it's not a horror movie, however, a large number of traumatized children would disagree with you. And while on the subject of trauma from people's childhoods, number 5. This would probably be the most vague and malleable concept for a haunted house since everyone was scared by different things as kids. That being said, as a frequent watcher and once contributor to the topic on YouTube, there are some recurring entries. I think a haunted house recreating the most common ones would be a really creative entry to an HHN event. Things like this video, or this scene. And you could even top it off with the scary maze since they frequently use the source of the pop-up image at the end as a maze already. Definitely an off-the-wall concept for a haunted house, but it could be a great nostalgia bomb for many people of my age. Number 4. The rest of my list is all comprised of houses based on musicians, ensuring that this video will not be able to be monetized. In the past few years, HHN has had mazes based on The Weeknd to great success. And in the past, they've had various other celebrity haunts as well. So it's only obvious to tap a genre that takes from horror both new and old.
And what better band to center a maze around than its most popular artist?
With such nightmarish imagery in many of their songs, and tons of lyrical storytelling to go off of, Metallica would be a perfect haunt. You could either weave through some of their iconic album covers realized as rooms, or you could base the rooms off of their popular songs. Either way, the idea would surely lend itself to a standout haunted house.
And while on the topic of heavy metal...
Number 3. Alongside the iconic haunted houses of HHN are scare zones. These basically function as an outdoor haunted house, but instead of a maze-like structure, they take up an area of the park and have no set path. The scare actors roam the area among the loose theming and scare guests as they walk through.
And for my one and only scare zone pitch, I've decided to go with...
This scare zone will be comprised of various monsters from iconic metal albums, just as the title suggests. Though there would be a one monster per band rule, so that this doesn't become a tribute to all metal but mostly Iron Maiden. Eddie would need to be there for obvious reasons, but also Dio's Holy Diver, Judas Priest's Painkiller Bikers, you could even project the skeletal bullet birds from Lamb of God's Ashes of the Wake on the walls, and so many other references dotted around the area, alongside blasting music that follows through from those albums. Now, all this begs the question, what if you're not a metal fan? Well, I've got you covered on that front as well. Number 2. Yeah, when the Weeknd was given his own scare maze, this was the first thing that popped into my head as a follow-up to it. It's literally the most iconic spooky music video ever made, and for some, the best music video ever made. The house could start at the Palace Theater as a facade, then go into the forest with Werewolf Michael scaring you, then move to the streets and eventually recreate the iconic zombie dance before ending in the house with one final Yellow Eyes Michael Jackson jump scare, and that iconic Vincent Price laugh to play you out as you exit. The only reason I can see them not doing it is absurd licensing costs and maybe not wanting to associate with MJ, but with the biopic coming next year and that biopic being distributed by Universal, maybe public opinion has shifted enough and we could get this no-brainer of a haunted house.
And for my last item on my list, we have the most unlikely to happen. You'll understand why as soon as I reveal what it is.
Number 1.
You may have noticed the asterisk in my ownership disclaimer. Well, there's one property on my list that I do have full ownership of, and that is...
Yeah. Call me a narcissist all you want, but as a musician and a fan of themed entertainment, of course I want my own haunted house. The concept would utilize the recent boom of vector graphics, synthwave music, and Tron imagery to create a virtual world of horrors where monsters of any kind can digitize in and terrorize the users. The rooms would all have black-lit glowing grids, laser effects, and circuitry adorning the walls using LEDs to light up the scare actors when not hidden. Essentially, this would be a full maze version of the Anarcade Scare Zone from 2019, but with less video game focus and more just a scary virtual world. I'd love to make this idea fully realized as a house at some haunt event. So if you'd like to make my dreams a reality, give me a call, Murdy.
So there's my list. Are there any of these entries that you love? Are there any of these entries that you hate? What's your personal list? Be sure to let me know down in the comments. Stay spooky.